In the Operations Manual, please reference the Installation section, subsection Create a Configuration Profile. Click the Setup icon on the left-hand side of the screen. Click on the Profile Management icon. This will bring you to the System Programming menu. Select the desired menu to define the system parameters. In the Service Do screen, you can select when the system prompts for a pump replacement, optics cleaning, and filter replacement. Clicking the on-off slide bar enables entering the desired time period between the allowable ranges shown on the screen. Clicking on the Events page allows you to set up whether Acknowledge Events is required before reset, whether the alarm or false are latching or not, then by clicking View Details, the alarm settings options appear. These options are whether you want an alarm delay between 1 and 250 seconds, whether you want the system to notify you if a pre-event or sub-LDL event is taking place, whether a Windows 0 reset has occurred, and whether you want the TWA mode as a fixed time and when do you want that first TWA to occur. Shown on the screen is 4 a.m. By clicking View Details on the Fault Settings, you can now select whether you want the system to report maintenance faults to you, if the chem cassette is stale, if excessive chem cassette usage is detected, and if you want to be notified when a low chem cassette is near anywhere from between 1 in 10 days. By clicking Timeout at the top of the screen, you can now set for the system to notify you if an analyzer has been out of monitor anywhere between 1 and 240 minutes or disabled. The same holds true for point disabled as well as alarm inhibit operations. By clicking Serial COM at the top of the page, you dictate whether you are using the Modbus RTU, what bit rate the data bits the parity set up, how many stop bits, and then the individual slave IDs, which is basically the address of the given analyzer on the Modbus network. The reason why this is editable is if you have multiple Vertex Edge units, Vertex Edge number 2 may start with 10 through 19 versus 1 through 9 as shown on the screen. By clicking Database at the top of the screen, you can tell the system when to automatically purge any historical data from the system. Please make sure you are following your company's data retention policies and any regulatory requirements for your area. The analyzer and point setup is discussed in a separate module. Once you are finished with your system configuration, you can name the profile by clicking the pencil at the very top of the screen, typing in what you wish it to be called, and click Save. After clicking Save, the Edit Profile screen will appear. You have four choices: discard it, do a file save as, save if you're editing an existing, and save and install. The system setup can be performed, and until save and install is selected, the Vertex Edge will continue to operate as it was prior to these settings being made. Once the final save has been completed, the Profile Manager screen will reappear. The right-hand side will show you all the different profiles that have been stored on the system with their time and date, as well as the profile name you have entered in prior to saving.